We start this noon with breaking news from Claremont County. Right now, four firefighters have been injured battling a four-alarm fire at a Union Township apartment complex. News 5's Christina Cruz is live on the scene with more breaking details. Christina, good afternoon.
As you mentioned, Lisa, a multiple alarm fire here. Chaos and commotion rang out at about 10 o'clock when we first heard word of these flames. We do want to show you a picture that we caught as one of those firefighters was being loaded into an ambulance. Obviously, he has some issues with the heat and oxygen-related problems here dealing with a fire of this magnitude. We know that this affects one building in the apartment complex, Randy Chase Apartments off 125. Now, a super saw flames near the rear of the building. He literally started knocking on doors, trying to get everybody out. Now, we are told that all the units that were rented, those folks were able to get out safely. But reports right now, one cat has not made it. Now, the fire started on the bottom of this three-floor building and made its way all the way up. And you can actually peer into a third-floor window and see the sky through where the roof used to be. So extensive damage, as you can imagine. Many of these units that we can see from our vantage point just blackened to a crisp. And as you can imagine, this really affects the people who lived in these units. And right now I want to introduce my colleague Allison Montoya, also covering this fire for us. We both met a gentleman getting married next week in one of these units where you can literally see the sky through his roof. He's lost everything, Allison.
Yeah, that's right, Christina. Thanks. And this guy and his fiancee, they are just devastated. As you guys can imagine, again, they're getting married next weekend. Everything's upstairs from decorations to money to, they just said everything's up there. They lost it all, so they have no idea what to do. Come next weekend. I'm sure they'll figure that out by then. But everybody here has a story. And Richard Trout, the gentleman we talked with, though, he said it was his fiance was the one that was at home and alerted him that he was or that this apartment complex was on fire and that he needed to come home. And here's what he had to tell us.
She sent me a text message and said our apartment's on fire. I need to come home. I had no idea if it was ours or, you know, the neighbors or what. So.
But what you're thinking, though, after all this, you guys are safe. See through and see the sky through to from their apartment because theirs was the one that the roof just collapsed. But everybody has a story here, though. I talked to the gentleman earlier. He said he didn't see or smell anything. He heard a bunch of firefighters and their trucks come by, and then he looked, went outside around to the back side of the building. That's when he saw all those flames. So he was like, thank goodness he was already out of the building. He stayed out. He's now kind of where the manager's office is, trying to stay cool here. Also, I talked with another couple. They're trying to get their way and make their way up to Dayton, Ohio for a wedding rehearsal. They're not for sure if they're going to be able to make it. So a lot of stories here and a lot of people, of course, without homes. Lisa, back to you.